Good evening, dear ladies. Let's bless the Siyata Dishmaya, Klal Yisrael, that we will all have a schut, that we will all have a schut Bezrat Hashem to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Bimera Bi'Ameinu, Amen, with mercy Bezrat Hashem. Eliyahu Miliyatish V'Le'agdim Yomshach V'Dabil Eliyahu Nizakur L'Tov. And we all have the schut to see Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi Bimera Bi'Ameinu, Amen. May we all have the schut to go to Eretz Yisrael Bezrat Hashem. And we all have the schut to have part in Eretz Yisrael. This lesson Bezrat Hashem is Le'ilui Nishmat. לואיזה לובה, בת חיים יצחק, הנולדת מלאה עליה, שלום תשנו בצרור החיים. ולילוי נשמת שרה, בת פנחס, הנולדת ממרים, עליה, שלום תשנו בצרור החיים. ולילוי נשמת אליהו בן יוסף ומלכדינה, עליו, שלום תשנו בצרור החיים. ולילוי נשמת אלכס בן שלומו, עליו, שלום תשנו בצרור החיים. And all of the souls that don't have anybody to say for them Kaddish, Bezrat Hashem, everybody will benefit from this. Bezrat Hashem. This week's parasha is Ba'alotcha, dear ladies. So, B'siyata Dishmaya, you can go to TorahAnytime.com, RabbanItirs.com, and also the YouTube. And you can enjoy Bezrat Hashem, a lesson about Parashat Ba'alotcha. Today, we're going, because it's the Yahrzeit, we're going to speak about something that is written in Bagmara, Masechet Shabbat, page 105. And it's written over there, Ha'omed al amet, bishat etziyat neshama, he who stands next to a person that is dying, in the moment that his soul goes out of his body, the soul goes out, chayav likoa, has to tear his clothes. What this, can you give an example for this? Lesefer Torah shenisrefa. This is parallel to a book of Torah that is burnt.
Wow.
Listen very carefully. When a person passes away and his soul goes out of his body, this is parallel to a book of Torah that is burnt.
Wow.
Now, how did Chazal, our sages, come to this? How they compared this to a book of Torah that is burnt? A soul that comes out of the body when a person passes away. So, B'siyata Dishmaya, I'm going to go to Bereshit. Bereshit Rabbah. And Bereshit Rabbah, it says like this. HaTorah Omeret, the Torah says, Ani hayiti kli umanuto shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I was the tool of Hashem. Benoach shebaolam melech basar v'dam bonet platin, as that custom in the world that when a king builds a castle, he takes people, you know, engineers, they takes them to make a drawing of the house, of the castle that he's going to build, all of the entrances, all of the windows, everything he needs to see in a drawing. And then after he sees this, they start working on it and prepare the building. Kach haya Kadosh Baruch Hu. That's how Hashem did. Haya mabit b'Torah v'boret ha'olam. Hashem was looking at the Torah and building, yes, creating the world. Who wrote the Torah? Hashem. Hashem was looking at the Torah and creating the world. V'Torah amra, and the Torah said, Bereshit bara Elokim, at the beginning Hashem created. Ve'ein reshit ela Torah, and there's no beginning except for Torah. He'ach, it's written in the Mishlei, Hashem kanani reshit dargo. It's written in Mishnei that Hashem bought me. I am the beginning of the way, which means the Torah is the beginning. Hashem was looking in the Torah and creating the world, the Siyata Dishmaya. Why did Hashem create the world? By looking at the Torah, for the children of Israel to study the Torah. Because the children of Israel is also called the beginning. Reshit bu'ata, dear ladies, in Yirmiyahu. In Yirmiyahu the prophet, it says, Reshit Bu'ata, the beginning of the harvest is the children of Israel. So the Torah is called the beginning, and the children of Israel are called the beginning. This is what we see, B'siyata Dishmaya v'Bereshit. Hashem was looking at the Torah and creating the world. We go to the Zohar HaKadosh, Parashat Yitro, and it says over there, remember Parashat Yitro, we are receiving the Torah. We just finished Shavuot. And it says, עשרת הדיברות של התורה, the Ten Commandments of the Torah, שהם שורש של הדדה, the root of the Torah, the Ten Commandments, הם בעצם עשר מאמרות שבהם נברא העולם. Listen very carefully. The Ten Commandments, which are the root of the Torah, they are really the 10 speeches in which Hashem created the world. When Hashem said, "Vayiro, let that be light," this comes from the 10 commandments. Yikavu mayim, that all of the water will go to one place. It's from the 10 commandments. How does it compare to this? You remember that sometimes I show you on the blackboard that we change letters et bash, like the aleph can be changed with a taf and bet with a shin, and various changes of letters. By changing the letters, by the rules that our sages gave us, which came from Moshe Rabbeinu on the mount of Ma'amad Har Sinai, on the mountain of Sinai, when Hashem gave him the Torah, you come from the 10 commandments to the 10 speeches in which Hashem created the world. So now let's go to Baal HaTanya. So Baal HaTanya, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, says Beshar HaYechud VaEmunah, he says like this, וידעת היום בישיבות האלה בבך כי השם הוא האלוקים בשמיים ממעל ועל הארץ מתחת אין עוד. You should know that Hashem is the God in heaven and on earth, and there's nothing else except Hashem, which means Hashem is everything, and everything is Hashem. God is everything, and everything is God, period. So look what he says. We're going to Tehillim, chapter 119, the letter Lamed. At the beginning of the letter Lamed, there's a verse, a sentence that is written, Pasuk. Le'olam Hashem barcha nitzav b'shamayim. Always Hashem, your speech is in heaven. And Arasha Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, Rabbi Shalom Sharabi Zchutot Hagen Aleinu Ben Yitzchak, says that on Yom Kippur we should say this verse 12 times. It's good to say that every day in the morning. Kidvarcha, your speech. You see, there are two kinds of speech in Hebrew. Yesh dibur, v'yesh amira. Dibur, dvarcha, is something harsh. When you're harsh, the amira is something soft. You speak softly. It's something soft. So here, l'olam asher dvarcha, dvarcha, it's very harsh, which means it's a decree that it's not so good. כשמדברים בחוזקה, it's a decree that is not so good. So it says, Arasha says, you say that 12 times, and any decree that is not good, we ask from Hashem to leave it in heaven, not to bring it on earth. Bezrat Hashem, that no problems we'll have over here. Leave it, maybe Bezrat Hashem will all do tshuva, and you don't have to bring this decree that is not good to earth, Bezrat Hashem. Mm-hmm. Now let's go back to Baal HaTanya. So he comes to this verse, and he says, always Hashem, your speech is in heaven. He says, "V'peresh al Baal Shem Tov," and the Baal Shem Tov Zchutot Hagen Aleinu says, "Ki dvarcha she'amarta," that your speech when you said, "Yehi rakia," let there be heaven, betoch hamayim, inside the water, teivot ve'otiyot elu, the words and the letters of what Hashem said, hen nitzavot ve'omdot le'olam betoch rakia hashamayim, they are always in heaven. Until today, yesterday, today, and tomorrow, the letters, the words, mamash, are there in heaven. And he says, "Eilu hen nitzavot ve'omdot le'olam betoch rakia shemayim u'mulubashot betoch kol harekiim le'olam lachiyotam." And they are always inside heaven, always, forever, in order to give livelihood to the creation. Which means when Hashem said Tichei Haaretz Deshe, which means there will be grass, these words are always around us. The words and the letters that the word that gives combination to the words are all around us. And it says B'siyata Dishmaya, L'achyotam K'dichti V'dvar Elokeinu Yakum Lo'olam V'dvarav Chayim V'Kayamim La'ad, which means the word of Hashem is forever. Ki'ilu hayu ha'otiyot, listen very carefully, if the letters and the words mistalkot kerega chas v'shalom will go out of this world, Hashem will erase them, take them back, v'chozrot limkoran, they go back to the root, to their root, hayu kol ha'shamayim ayin ve'efes mamash, which means there won't be any heaven, won't be any sky, if the words and the letters והיו כלא היו כלל, like it wasn't and ever. וכמו קודם אמר ירקיה, וכן כל הברואים, which means all of the creation, animals, human beings, plants, everything, the earth, sky, all of the stars, dear ladies, listen very carefully. If the words and the letters won't be in order to give livelihood still today and will be Bezrat Hashem, if they will go, if Hashem will bring them back to their source, all of the world goes back to chaos. There's no world anymore. All is over. All of the world goes back to chaos. No world anymore. Nobody is here. That's why when the children of Israel went out of Egypt and they were in front of the ocean and Hashem opened the ocean, they saw that Hashem is inside the air. That everything that is around them, Hashem is in it. Hashem gives his livelihood to everything that is in this world. You understand? Without Hashem, there's no livelihood to the world. That's it. There's no world. So how does he give the livelihood? Through the letters. You remember Hashem gave me this to give you a lesson about the power of the name of a person? Because we have livelihood by the letters of our name. That's why it's so important when we call a name to a baby, to a child, that it will be a good name, Bezrat Hashem. So all of the letters give us livelihood. So it says, Omer Bala Tanya, you are closer to the camera, and I don't have a microphone. So Omer Bala Tanya B'Siyata Lishmaya, in the name of a Baal Shem Tov Zchuto Tegen Elenu, that if the words and the letters wouldn't have been all around us, of the speech, of the 10 speeches of Hashem when he created the world, there won't be any world, nothing, no chair, no table. You understand that all of this has the livelihood of Hashem. All of this, everything that you see over here, it looks like it's still, but it's not still. It has molecules, atoms, and they have vibrations inside. It's not still. It is dressed up with a livelihood that Hashem gave it. You understand? So, dear lady, that's what Bala Tanya says in the name of Baal Shem Tov Zchuto Tegen Elenu. So, B'Siyata Dishmaya, let's continue. We come to Masechet Avodah Zarah. And במסכת עבודה זרה, it says like this, page 5, it says, אמר רבי שמעון בן לקיש, said רבי שמעון בן לקיש, מה בכתיב, ויהי ערב ויהי בוקר יום השישי. What does it mean when it's written in the creation at the beginning that there will be night and morning, the sixth day, Friday, בסייעתא דשמיא. מלמד שהתנה הקדוש ברוך הוא מעשה בראשית, which means Hashem made a condition with Ma'aseh Bereshit, with creation at the beginning. Ve'amar, and Hashem said, in Israel, if the children of Israel mekablim et haTorah, are accepting the Torah, mutav, it's good. Ve'im lav, and if they are not accepting the Torah, hareini machzir etchem letovavo. All of the world goes back to chaos. Do you understand? So let's see, this is very interesting. It says that if the children of Israel are accepting the Torah, then all of this world has an existence, has a livelihood. But if the children of Israel are not accepting the Torah, all of this world goes back to chaos. You know, the nations should protect us if they would understand this, because we are atone for the whole world. On how do we atone also for the nations? On Musaf Shel Sukkot, you remember, Hashem gave me the Zechut to give you a whole shiur about it. We give sacrifices the whole 7 days parallel to the 70 nations, in order that everybody will prosper and have food and have good parnas, a good income. And if the nations would understand this, they would be the ones that would take all of the children of Israel, bring them back to the land of Israel, and see that they will sit and study Torah and do the will of Hashem. So we see, B'Siyata Dishmaya, that there's a condition with creation, that if the children of Israel will study the Torah, then B'Siyata Dishmaya, there's existence and livelihood to the world. And if they won't, there's no livelihood to the world. So first of all, the world, we know, number one, Aleph, that Otiyot HaTorah the letters of the Torah, מקיימות את העולם. Give livelihood to the world. Because they are still there. לעולם השם ברכה ניצב בשמיים. They are all in heaven, all around us. All of the 10 speeches that Hashem created the world. Second thing, we know that the children of Israel have to study Torah, בעזרת השם. ישראל לומדים תורה. We'll study Torah. That gives the livelihood בסייעתא דשמיא to the whole world. So it's written בעזרת השם, בקדושת הלוי, בפרשת במדבר, it's written שהתורה הקדושה, in the holy Torah, יש 60 ריבותיות, there are 600,000 בסייעתא דשמיא letters, שהן מכוונות כנגד 60 ריבו שורשי נשמות ישראל, and they are parallel to 600,000, okay, 600,000 בסייעתא דשמיא, roots of the souls of the children of Israel, בעזרת השם. כל נשמה מכוונת כנגד אות אחת בתוכה. Every soul is parallel to one letter in the Torah. It includes the written Torah and the oral Torah, because the written Torah has approximately 300,000, a little bit more than that, 300,000 letters, but the Tirgum of the written Torah has the completion of the 600,000, I will say 60 rivo, you'll understand, 600,000 b'siyata d'shmaya letters. Who is parallel to the letters? The men are parallel to the letters. How was the Torah written? So when the children of Israel were standing around Ma'amad Har Sinai, but they were receiving the Torah, they saw the letters, they saw the voice, the kolot, הם שמעו את הקולות, הם ראו את הקולות, they saw the kolot, which means they saw the letters. What did they see? They see אש שחורה על אש לבנה. They saw how the letters, it's a black fire on a white fire. What is the white fire? The klaf, the amulet on which the Torah is written. The black fire is the letters on it. Who is, dear ladies, the white amulet? Us women. Us women are the white amulet. The white amulet. Who are the letters? The letters are the men. That's why a man is not completed unless he gets married. That's why it's written that even if he studies Torah all of his life, he didn't get married, he doesn't have any Torah. He doesn't have Torah, he doesn't have blessing, and he doesn't have the holy presence, Shekhinah, around him. Why? Because he didn't marry a wife. Why? Because the letter cannot stay in air. It has to be an amulet, a white amulet. Klaf. So the amulet, the part that is behind it, that the letter is written on it, this part is his wife and this is him. I won't continue, but it's a beautiful lesson about marriage and the completion of a husband and wife and being called a human being, Adam, b'siyata d'shmaya. So this b'siyata d'shmaya, we can see that there were 600,000 letters b'ezrat Hashem. There's a hint in the word Israel. Israel. The initials of Israel, Yesh, Shishim, Rivo, Otiyot, La Torah. And if you look at it, this is at the initial. You see Israel? I will explain. Yes, in a minute I'll translate. You see Israel? There, Yesh, Yud is for there. Shishim, 60. Resh, Rivo, which means 600. Rivo is 10,000, okay, in Hebrew, which means 600,000 otiyot letters, la Torah, to the Torah. You see it over here? This is Mekdushat HaLevi, ומגלה עמוקות זכותות הגן עלינו. This is ממגלה עמוקות. He says this is the hint that there are 600,000 letters and the children of Israel are parallel to it. In, you remember, Hashem gave me also a zechut to give you a shiur about the Ten Commandments. At the beginning Hashem says, Anochi Hashem Elokecha. You remember that? Mm-hmm. And it's the initials of Anochi is Anna Nafshit Ktivat Yehavit, which means Hashem says, Anochi, I am Hashem your God. But he says Anochi, the initials of the I am in Hebrew, the initial is in Aramaic, that I put my essence, I put all of my essence inside the letters of the Torah. Which means if you come to a Torah lesson and you study, and we are studying the Torah, then the letters of the Torah that now Hashem gives me to give you, may give you livelihood and give you, protect you. And when you go back home, you're protected. Like I showed you, you remember when we study, I give you from the Gemara. So the Gemara, you're going out of here with angels surrounding you because the Gimel is a Malach Gabriel. And the Mem is Michael. And the Reish is Raphael. And the Aleph is Oriel. You see, so you have the all of the Gemara we are studying. We are awakening good angels, good advocates, just to go with you home. So we are protected. We come once a week together as women over here to hear the lesson. And when you go home, you feel this energy because you get the livelihood from the letters of the Torah, because of Hashem put His essence inside the letters of the Torah. Ad kedei kach, dear ladies. So just so now we know the third thing that we know, Bezrat Hashem, that everyone, every Israel, mechuvanim, that are parallel to Otiyot HaTorah. Which means each one is parallel to a letter in the Torah. Besiyata Dishmaya, Omer Amor Enayim, Rabbi Menachem Nachum Mitchernovil, Zchudot HaGanelel, he says in Parashat Chukat, he says this, בסייעתא דשמיא. He says, ידוע כי יש סמך ריבו אותיות לתורה. That it's known that there's 600,000 letters to the Torah. וכנגדן יש סמך ריבו שורשי נשמות בישראל. And parallel to them is 600,000 roots of soul of the children of Israel, he says. And he says, that's why that Oraita, Kutcha Birichu, Oraita, V'Yisrael Chadem, the Zohar Kadosh says that Hashem, God, and the Torah, and the children of Israel are one. That we are all one. Because in order to have livelihood to the world, we have to study the Torah which Hashem looked at the Torah and created the world. And without this, the whole world goes back to chaos. There's no world, nothing. In a minute, there's nothing over here. It's like in a dream. Once it's here, and then the second, after the Chas V'Shalom, there's nothing. So, dear ladies, it says like that. הוא אומר, שבקרב האדם הוא ממש אותו האות שמשם שורש נשמתו. He says that a person, that every son of the children of Israel, he's ממש the letter that is in the Torah, that his soul is connected to it, that he came to fix over here. מה אומר על זה ארוגות הבושם? ארוגות הבושם says this. He says בסייעתא דשמיא, that when the children of Israel, you know, it's written, בכל העם רואים את הקולות, and all of the people were seeing the voices. So like I told you, they saw the letters, they saw the words. Furthermore, after that, it says, וירא וינו. They saw the letters and they started moving. Each one moved. Who moves when the king is speaking? He says, Anochi Hashem Elokecha. Who moves? Nobody wants to move. But when they saw, they were so spiritual. Each one saw the letter that he came to fix. From what word it comes from the Torah. For example, if Ploni ben Ploni, Shimon, he says, wow, I am Bereshit, the bet of Bereshit, of beginning. I am the bet. The first letter of the word beginning. So he saw, and then he sees his friend over there, Yuda. He is Reish, from the word Bereshit. So they started moving and standing one next to another, just like the words. Every letter came together. Each one knew exactly. And their wives were behind. Because you can't write a word without an amulet on it. So each one moved. And they mamash like the words of the Torah. I know it's very touching. Each one of them, because they saw the letters. So they move now, bidyuk moze, bidyuk like the words of the Torah. So you see, HaTorah ktuba be'esh chora al gabe'esh levana, that the Torah was written with black fire on white, on white fire, Bezrat Hashem. The white fire is the women, the black fire is the men. The black fire means the letters that are written in black ink, and the white is the amulet that holds the letters on it. So he says, listen very carefully. What he says, it's very important. Ve'ot mashpia al adam shefa v'chayut ha'kdusha, and the letter that the person is parallel to, it gives him livelihood and holiness. Ve'tzarich lida ke'ot shore b'peh, b'peh adam. And you should know that the letter is in the mouth of the human being. Kama chashuv what we say out of our mouth. V'chol ot kalul mikol ha'torah. And every letter is part of the whole Torah, because it's a letter inside the Torah, inside a word, that inside a sentence, a pasuk, inside of a chapter, inside of a parasha, a portion of the week, and it's part of the whole Torah. Mikol haTorah nimtza shekol haTorah bepe adam, that all of the Torah is in the mouth of a human being. Ki halo sefer Torah shechaser mimena ot achat psula. If a letter is missing for the book of Torah, or a letter is missing a part of the letter, the whole book of Torah, you can't read from it. Upasul, you have to fix it and then you can read from it. One letter, dear ladies. Ve'ena nechshevet la'Torah mitam ze, ki kol ot chashuv Torah bitzteref kulam yachad. Because each letter is important and all of them together are the Torah. וכל עבודת השם הכל הוא בזה שצריך האדם לקרב לשורשו. And all of the work of Hashem is all dependent on this, that each one needs to come to its root, בסייעתא דשמיא, to the root of the letter that belongs to him. דיינו התורה היא קומה שלמה תרי"ג מצוות ואדם כלול מרמ"ח איברים ושס"ה גידים. The Torah includes all of the 630 commandments from the Torah, and also the seven commandments of our sages, which is a keter, a crown together, and also a human being has 248 organs and 365 veins, 630 besiyata tishmaya, just the commandments of the Torah. And if chas v'shalom, one is missing, that we cannot read from the Torah. Do you understand how much everybody here is important? If one of the sons of the children of Israel, one of the daughters of the children of Israel, is not here, missing, is not here, it means that the book of Torah is missing. And if the book of Torah is missing a letter, then we can't read from the book of Torah. We have to go and fix it. This is the unity of the children. That's why we all, b'siyata d'shmaya, are responsible for each other. So he says, the Ma'orenayim, he says, ולכן, that's why the Arizal says, before you start davening, before you pray in the morning, you say, הרי אני מקבל עליי מצוות עשה, I'm accepting upon myself a commandment of doing, ואהבת לך כמוך אני השם. That I will love each Jew like I love myself. Why? Because without one letter in the Torah, the whole Torah is like burnt. One missing letter. So we can't afford ourselves that nobody will be missing. We are all important. The women are the amulet on which the Torah is written, the letters are written, and the men are the letters themselves. So he says, what is the essence of tshuva, of repenting? So the essence is, first of all, the Rambam says you have to have regret. Charata, נכון? תסתכלו, charata, בסייעתא דשמיא. So dear ladies, you have to regret charata. What does it mean? Like, why does the Hebrew word for regretting is charata? Because it comes charat, the letter hey. Mishom tshuva, tshuva repent, tshuv hey. You see, to bring back, to fix malchut. That's that hey, the last hey of the name of Hashem Yud Kei Vav Kei. אבל מה זה charat? Charat means to draw,
to engrave,
to engrave, dear ladies. What does it mean? It means because we didn't listen to the will of Hashem, we caused damage in the letter that is parallel to the root of our soul in the Torah, and because we damaged the letter, we caused a problem in reading the Torah. You cannot read the whole Torah because there's a problem with one of the letters. So in order to fix it, we have to engrave back the letter by doing tshuva, by repenting and having regret, charata. So together it's ממש לחרות. It's written בסייעתא דשמיא בסופה יוד גימל in the Gemara, page 13. It's written, Moshe Rabbeinu is considered Safra Rabba di Israel. He is considered Moshe Rabbeinu Safra Rabba, which means Sofer, a writer. The writer of the children of Israel. Why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu was the leader, the king of the children of Israel. And he taught them, each one of them, to what letter they are connected. And he made them connected to the root of the letter. And because it did this, it's like he's the writer. לכן זאת התורה שציווה משה, תורת משה. That's why the Torah is named by Moshe Rabbeinu. Because he caused awakening in each soul of the Jewish people to awaken to the letter that is part of the root of their soul. So dear ladies, let's connect everything. בסייעתא דשמיא, we understand the first thing that the letters of the Torah, that Hashem was looking at the Torah and creating the world. And the letters of the Torah are still all around us. The words are still, the 10 speeches of Hashem are all around us. Like the Baal Shem Tov says, otherwise all of this world will go back to Tohu Vavohu. What gives livelihood to all of this creation? The children of Israel that study Torah, בסייעתא דשמיא. And Israel lomdim Torah, and then each one of the children of Israel, each one of the men is parallel to a letter from the Torah, and the women is the klaf, the amulet behind it. So when a person passes away, what happens? When a person passes away, what happens, dear ladies? A letter from the book of Torah goes out of this world. So the Torah is missing a letter now. That's why you have to tear the cloth, because it's compared to a Sefer Torah shenisrafa, to a book of Torah that is burned because it's missing a letter. What does Hashem do? In another place, a child comes to this world with the same letter to complete it. Wow. One goes out and one comes in.
Wow.
If b'siyata dishmaya, it's a woman, part of the klaf, part of the amulet is missing, which the letter was written on. The letter can't stand without the amulet, without the white fire. So when she, Chas v'Shalom, passes away, there's another child, another girl that comes in order to complete the book of Torah.
Oh my God.
Look, so I want you to see something. That's why, look how beautiful it's written. במועד קטן, בסייעתא דשמיא בגמרא, it's written, הרואה ספר תורה שנקרא, he who sees a book of Torah that is torn, חייב לקרוא, has to tear his cloak. You see a book of Torah that is torn, part of it is torn, you have to cut the clothing. Two cuts, not one. Not like when a person is passing away. Why? אחד על הגביל, one for the amulet, which is for the women, and the second one for the כתב, the letters. That's why when you see a book of Torah that is torn, אומרים במועד קטן, you have to tear two tears on the cloth, one for the klaf, the amulet, that the Torah is written on it, and the second one for the letters themselves, two torn. And when a person passes away, it's one torn. Why? Because if it's a man, it's for the letter. Mm-hmm. If it's for the woman, if it's a woman that passes away, it's for the amulet on which the letter was written on. And with these words, I would like to bless all of us, בעזרת השם, שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן, ברחמים בעזרת השם. We all, בעזרת השם, have the זכות to see and hear אליהו הנביא זכור לטוב. לעולם יפרד אדם מחברו בדבר הלכה, יחיד ברבים, הלכה כרבים.